Hello guys, welcome back to Tech Genesis. I'm Wale and today I'll be giving you guys the summary of everything that happened in yesterday's Apple Spring event. It was a really cool event and we got a lot of insight to their latest technology that is going to be coming out now and some updates to the previous things that they had before. We first met Tim Cook, the CEO of Apple, and he was the one that introduced the first product of the day, which was the Apple's credit card. We all know what the Apple credit card is, just that unfortunately not a lot of countries use credit card the way Americans use it, calculating the point system and all. Not all countries, I'm currently in Spain, we don't use this point system. If you need loan, you can just go to the bank and ask for loan, and they'll just give you all the loan you have before. If you have any outstanding loan and you have any job, that's what they'll just give you. They don't award it based on point system. So I think almost everything that was talked about the credit card is majority for those people in the Americans. They also talk about all the updates they made on the Apple card, and also the next product that was talked about is the Apple podcast, where people upload their podcast, which I think is one of the cool thing Apple does. That is another way for people, for content creator, to earn money. And I think since I'll be creating a podcast in the future, I think I'll be able to use that website to create content, which is really really cool and to be an extra way to earn income. Tim Cook also introduced the first device of the day, which is the color purple iPhone 12. This is the first time we're seeing color purple in any iPhone product, and I believe this iPhone 12 will have the same features with the previous iPhone. There won't be any change there, and now we have a total of 6 colors in the iPhone 12 range, which is really really cool. If you ask me, I think iPhone are the ones that only have most of the color in any other phone. I think there is other phone that have maybe 3 or 4, but iPhone manages this time around, which is really good. Then we were introduced to Find Mine, which is an app tracker. You can use that Find Mine to track your Apple products anywhere they get lost. For example, you can use to track your iPad, your iMac, your MacBook, any of your device at all. You can use it to track them wherever they are, both online and offline. It doesn't matter at all. That is a new tech Apple implement in all your product. Now A14 chip device will have it, but I don't know if lesser chip device are going to have it too. I'm really not keen about that, but I believe if Apple are going to do like that, they are going to give every of their products, it doesn't matter if it is A14 or not, they are going to give every one of them, which is really really cool. And if you are not using an Apple product or Apple device, if you want to track any third party device that does not have any affiliate with Apple, you can track that using the Airtag. That was the next product we were told about. The Airtag will allow you to track any of your device wherever they are and whenever you place them. You can just tag it on your device, and once you tag it on any device you want to search for, then you can use the Find Mine on your Apple phone to track the device or object you are looking for. But the main issue with this is privacy concern, and Apple addressed that. They said with an iPhone you can use to detect any unwanted AirTag that is on your body or that is around you. But the thing is that if you are not using an iPhone, how are you going to know that someone is stalking you with an AirTag? And stalking is one of the dangerous things currently, especially celebrities. They are suffering from stalking a lot. But how is Apple going to do that? So I think the AirTag might fail because of that. Even the privacy that they are really concerned about is talking about Apple, not any other product. Because as now, as I'm using a Realme phone, if someone puts an AirTag on me, I can't know because I'm using a Realme phone. I'm not using an Apple phone. So I think that would be the major problem with Apple, unless they can look for a way to share the Find Mine on every other devices, which I think Apple will be reluctant to do, but they don't have any choice in that at all, because by the time more people are complaining about their privacy, they will have to do something about it. They are going to share it to other phone or other tech. I won't lie, the AirTag is a very very good idea, but just has some flaw which I think can be corrected. And the next device we introduced to is the Apple TV. So guys, this one is very very funny, because the Apple TV is just a little box like this, a little rectangular black box, and they write Apple on it. And whenever I saw that in a second hand shop, I really don't know what it was, because I already saw Apple on it, but I know that it's an Apple product, but I don't know the function at all. I actually don't know how it works. Not until yesterday that it was unveiled that it was an Apple TV. I was really surprised. What? I really thought maybe it was something like maybe the Siri for Apple. I think that was the Siri for Apple. That's what I always thought it was. Not until when I heard that it was the Apple Smart TV. I really don't know how it works, because I don't have one and I have never seen one before. Though I have seen one, but I have not seen how it really works. That is why I really don't know anything about the Apple Smart TV. Maybe one day I'm going to see how they use it and all. Then I'll understand more about the Apple TV. It was really, really fun when I saw that. I laughed myself out. And also they talk about the remote control, how they upgrade the remote control and how you can use it, how it is the best remote control out there, and also the Apple TV. And one thing they say they increase with the Apple TV is that they put more channel into it, and also I think the storage is more bigger than the one they have the last time. I really don't know how it works, but those of you that are using the Apple TV, I'm sure you guys know how it works. And for the next device, which is a very important device for the Apple for now and for the future, the device is the M1 chip, which is a replacement to their Intel chip, the one they normally used before. I don't know the generation of Intel they use, but this M1 chip is the one that is going to replace Intel. We know that Apple have been trying to develop their own personal chip, just like Samsung was doing with their Exynos chip, but that Samsung Exynos chip is trash. That is true, they don't lie, it is trash, and they are cheating us with that we are living outside US. They are giving us rubbish chip and giving the Americans a better chip. That is one thing Apple cannot do, and that is what I love their product though. I don't have any of their products. And their M1 chip will be replacing the Intel chip in both their iMac and also in their iPad, but I don't think they are using the Intel chip for the iPad. Maybe they are using another chip. I really don't know much about the iPad. And for the iMac, if you see the new iMac that they unveiled, it is more better and good looking than the previous iMac. It is slimmer and the design is very, very good. And now they are up to 7 different colors. I think the colors are really cool. They really showcase the color well, and they also showcase every update they did on this new iMac, which is making it better than before. A better upgrade, the more upgrade they do, the more money you are going to spend for sure. I think I have forgotten how much they sold the last one. Is this $6,000 worth? I think maybe around that region. And this one will be very expensive. I think it will be, maybe if it is not even more expensive, it will be around that region also. That is still expensive if you ask me. Another accessories too was introduced along with the iMac, and they are the iMac mouse, the iMac mousepad, and the iMac keyboard. The coolest there is the iMac keyboard, and there are three types of iMac keyboard. If you see, there are three types, they are really cool, but my favorite among the three is the one with the Touch ID. That is insane. You can use that to unlock your iMac just like you do on your phone. I think that was really cool, and I thought that was the best thing for me. And if I'm going to get an iMac, that is the one I'm getting, because it was really, really cool. And also they also talk about how you can connect your iPhone and your iPad easily to the iMac, which are one of the things I like about Apple. I've said it before, the ecosystem is one of the best. The way you can connect from this one to this one is really, really good. And the best thing they did about the iMac is that they did the iMac in a way that is like similar to the iPhone. The apps they use are similar, so you can use the same app you're using on your iPhone, the same thing too on your iMac, which is really, really cool. And they show how they integrate their technology, and you can just take something from your phone and put it on your iMac and continue with whatever you are doing. It was just cool. It was really, really cool. I enjoyed that. Maybe that is what is going to motivate me to get an Apple product. And the last product we introduced to is the iPad Pro. Like I said before, the iPad Pro also came with the M1 chip, and the M1 chip made the iPad Pro very, very powerful. The processing power is something else. And they're just like the middleman, just in the middle of an iPhone and a computer. What an iPhone can do, it can do it. And what a computer can do, it can do it. It's not like the match of those two products, which is really insane. It was really, really cool, and I saw the design. Anybody can use it, a professional editor, a professional photographer. That is how insane it is. And the iPad Pro comes in both the 11 inch display and the 12.9 inch display with a memory of 2 terabytes. You guys have that 2 terabytes of memory. That is way more bigger than the one on my computer system. That is insane. 2 terabytes, jeez, that is big. It is huge. It also comes in two different colors. We have the white and the black, and I think this is the first time we are getting the white. They talked about it too, that they're having the white for the first time. And you can even use the iPad with a keyboard, with a special keyboard that comes with it, which can just turn it into a laptop. Especially if you get the one of the 12 inch display, it is insane, man. They also talk about how good the camera of the iPad Pro is, but no numbers were given. We don't know the megapixel or what sensor that were used. I think they don't really talk about that. Let's talk about how you can use it to photograph, use it to edit, make video edits, that's all what they talk about, but they didn't really talk about the sensor and all. The 11 inch iPad Pro comes at the price of $799, while the 12 inch display iPad Pro comes at the price of $1,099. I don't know what the price will be in every other countries. And out of the whole product that was introduced yesterday, I think both the iMac and the iPad Pro were the coolest of everything. I really enjoy seeing them a lot, and seeing their new features, it blew my mind. And if I have enough money, they'll be the one for me to get. And also, before I forgot, we also told that for gaming on the iPad Pro, you can use a PS5 or Xbox console, which was really insane. I think that was the best thing in the show. It was the coolest thing at all, especially using a PS5 console for your iPad. And that is the under level of insane, really, if you're not going out with it, holding it, or you're forcing you playing PS5 with your iPad. Just think about that. That is cool. And that is really cool. I think that was the most impressive thing about the presentation. That is to me. But for you, what was the most impressive thing? What was the product you loved the most that was unveiled yesterday? I'll be looking forward to more Apple products in the future, and I don't think it will take me time before I start using an Apple device. Like I said before, because of the ecosystem, I don't think any device come near at all to the ecosystem of Apple. And at the rate with which it is moving, so I don't think any device is going to come close soon enough. And if any device won't come close, it will be Google for sure, because I think Google is more balanced in all an ecosystem than any other product out there, even more than Samsung too, I think Google. But I don't see any device getting ahead of Apple anytime soon, which is insane. I really love that about Apple, and maybe that is what will make me change my mind towards Apple. That is if money is not a factor. So guys, if you enjoyed the video, a like will be very fantastic. And remember guys, stay safe and stay healthy. Peace.